ます。
Cavan O'Claw, Curse Kathleen.
Captain of the present, the old captain, the old vice captain, ladies and gentlemen, I hope today you've had an enjoyable captain's day and an outcome of the formal proceedings. To get the proceedings underway, I'd like to ask the lady captain, Ruth Barrett, to come up and say a few words.
Captain, ladies and gentlemen, Captain Future is now Captain Present. He has come out of the closet, wardrobe, and he's put his panto career on hold until the next time. Having taken very early retirement, he took on the role of Captain with vigour, or was that Viagra? He's been up here most nights giving the ladies his full support. And on behalf of all the lady members, I would like to thank him for our prizes tonight. On a personal level, I would like to take this opportunity to thank him for his encouragement to me all year and congratulate him on overcoming the weather crisis this morning so admirably. All the ladies wish him continued success for his captaincy, and I know he will enjoy the rest of this evening. Thank you.
Thank you, Lady Captain. I'm about to call on a man. Is anybody in the clubhouse that doesn't know that he comes from Fermanagh? Some of us might know it from our plan tomorrow. But calling your captain for 2006 Patty Burns, all the way from Vermont. Mr. Vice Captain, Mr. President, Lady Captain, Lady Vice Captain, guests, ladies and gentlemen. I just first of all would like to thank Ruth, our Lady Captain, this year for those kind words. She was a wonderful girl, you know. I just wish I got paid a wee bit of mixed golf, you know, or whatever. But, you know, since she went to Scotland and fell off a buggy and hurt her arm, that hasn't been possible. But maybe towards the end of the year, from now to the closing stages of the golf season, we never know what we might get up to. We might play a round or two if Peter allows us. Yeah. First of all, I'd just like to welcome everybody here this evening to the presentation of prizes and all the boogie was going to go on afterwards for 2006. I hope everybody had a good day. Now, there was a lot of different things happening, the ladies putting, people actually playing in the competition, people who just attended the coffee morning this morning, and maybe just arrived here tonight. So whatever you did, I hope you've enjoyed the day. And I hope it continues in the wee small hours. Somebody said, why did Burns have his Captain's Day at the end of July? And I was beginning to wonder that this morning. Traditionally, it's always usually the last Saturday in June, a week after Lady Captain's Day, but I just thought it'd be a good idea to have it to keep the club alive. And that was the, I could have had it on the 1st of July, the 8th of July, the 15th of July, the 22nd of July. All beautiful Saturdays. And I had it today. At least, it was raining this morning, it was tough conditions, but there was tough conditions last night for the golfers as well. The 120 golfers or so that were out last night and played. So I don't think, Marty hasn't told me, I don't even know who's won, I don't know what scores they are, I don't want to know until Marty tells us later on, but nobody can say, oh, if I had been playing on Friday, I would have won. Or if I had been playing on Saturday, I would have won. So I think conditions were tough on both days, and I think maybe from 11 o'clock onwards, maybe we got the best of it today. Apparently, there was a couple of guys coming, one guy was coming up the clubhouse after his round of golf yesterday, and Alan, the pro, we met him, he says, just what's wrong with you? You must have a lousy round of golf today. He says, I only hit two good balls all day, he says. I walked out of the bunker and I stamped on a rake. I know that's a bit of a joke, all right, but at a quarter past eight this morning, there was no joke at all. I went down to the first tee at 5-7 this morning, and the big hitter Mark Fraser hit off with his 2-iron onto the 18th green. I knew it was going to be a difficult day for the boys. I hope Mark's not here, but he'll probably hear about it anyway. At least they finished. They finished the 18 holes through pick and pin. But seriously, about 8:45, Ian O'Hay, a member of council, rang me and I got the phone over there and he said, Paddy, second hole's flooded, boy. Get the buggy, come out and have a look at it. And I wasn't a happy camper. I was getting my prizes together at that stage. And it was nerve-wracking. And of course, there's always a character that puts a hand on his shoulder and says, calm down, Paddy, because you know I'm a wee bit irritable, as people say, you know. No? There's always McNanny. He's always there, and he put his hand on his shoulder. He says, Paddy, take it easy, just wait, and so on and so forth. But it was looking very bad, seriously. It was looking bad this morning. And so when I drove up the road to the house, just up the top of the road there, and the rain was hitting the windscreen, and I went to the house, and I went, jeez, what's happened here, you know? And I looked at the calendar, and it says, open week. This is the thing I've been driving, this open week. Can't have it next Saturday or the following Saturday. And it happened the 19th of August. That's the August medal gone.
Just happened to have Captain say that day. But as it worked out, we held on, and I was delighted that Tom went out, and Tom rang in and says, "Paddy, the Greens are playable." And he's, you know, I just didn't want to become another Donald McEnany. I was hit with that word so many times this morning that in about 2 hours, like, McEnany. See you guys who live in Captain O'Carr Park. You couldn't organise any captaincy, you know. Anyway, enough about this morning. You know, it doesn't seem 7 months ago that I was looking forward to the 1st of January to be installed as the captain. It was great, you know. When I was vice captain, I thought, it had to be miles away. I know it was something happened, and now it's 7 months away, and 5 months' time, Jack, you'll be there. Okay. But it's gone very, very quickly, and it has been entirely enjoyable. I said on the 1st of January up here, with a packed house, the 1st of January is always a great day in Armagh Golf Club. It's a wonderful occasion, the inauguration of the captain and the president. And I remember saying I was privileged and honoured and a little bit humbled to be captain of County Armagh. And I'm still feeling that way, and particularly as a Fermanagh man down here. And I think the first Fermanagh man, only Fermanagh man, apparently Jack O'Hare has worked out, there's no other Fermanagh man who's been captain in 113 years. But I also made a quote that day about a very famous footballing man, about him, I think, you know, I'm not going to mention his name, I quoted what he quoted when he received the Sam Maguire in 2003, and I certainly won't quote him tonight, because Brendan Smith will walk out of this hall and he'll never speak to me again. And you know, I don't want to fall out with Brendan, because Brendan's a great man for getting you tickets for the lower deck of the Hogan Stand or the Cusick Stand. And I certainly want to be friendly with him, because on the 17th of September, I want to be there watching the All Ireland final between Dublin and Fermanagh. Sorry, you're heckling. Seriously, it's great we can have a bit of banter about the football, about the golf, and so on and so, but I've been living in this town for 35 years and I just love it. About 18 years ago, I was tempted to head up to Enniskillen and saw a post that maybe attracted me. And then I said, no, I know everybody in this town. I wouldn't leave it. And that's the way it has been. And I'm just going to deviate just for 2 seconds, or well, maybe 2 minutes. I know Ian Doss is over there saying, when Bourne gets up, he'll never stop. I don't know where, is Dossie over there? I'm lost. I was going to deviate just a wee bit from the club. I would have liked to have the opportunity. I retired there about a couple of years ago. Got early retirement, big lump sum, brilliant. And there was 8 of us. And you know, tradition in the tech, and I have always been involved with presentations of staff going and so on, and I know Florence McGaw is here, and I'm glad that Florence is here. We would always be involved in raising money and getting the presents and stuff like that for years. And of course, Florence on her own getting sorting out my present and all the other people who were retiring. But through lack of courtesy or not knowing what he was doing, the director didn't give us an opportunity to even thank the people for, or even say something about our 35 years in college or whatever. So I'm saying it now, I would like to thank, you know, people like Florence who got me a beautiful present 2 years ago down the club. Thanks a lot, Florence. And there's another couple that are here tonight, and that have to be here, that made me so welcome when I come to Armagh, and particularly when I got married, and made me feel very welcome. They live in 28 Rosemont Avenue, Armagh. Now, they live in a big flashy house now. And that was, and I wanted to thank them at the college sort of farewell, but as I said, I wasn't allowed to do it, we were censored. That's all of our Daily Screams. Yeah. Thanks. I'm just running on a team of sort of the college. There's a couple, a touring couple actually, and I hope Brendan doesn't mind that. Frances and Frances Mooney, who wanted to be here tonight, but Frances has been very ill. She's a devoted member of the staff down there, and she sent her wet wishes, couldn't be here. When I started playing, I played a lot of Gaelic football, and was still playing up in Fermanagh. And I never thought of playing golf, I thought it was for old boys. So I decided to join the rugby club down there, and I played maybe 10 or 12 years down the road, really enjoyed it. And then often I said, why didn't I join the golf club, you know? I could have been a single handicapper now, you know? Only a couple of shots away, like, but I could have been. But golf is great, it's, you get a bug for it. As Neil Trujillo said, you know, he's never had so much fun with his clothes on. I came into the club, you know, there's membership fees now and all sorts of things. Pat Russell, God rest him, said to me, Paddy, why are you going to join the club? You could be a novice member. Now, I don't know what he meant by that, you know, would it be a really bad golfer? But it was a novice membership, you know, just helping for members at that time. And I think the full membership was 80 quid or 90 quid or something. I got in for 45, but because it was halfway through the year, it was half that again, about 23 quid. So it was great value. And you know, when I started playing, a lot of the football guys said to me, Paddy, Jesus, you play right-handed, but you're left-footed, and you've only got one foot and you play football, you're left-footed, no. And that reminds me of a story about a guy that come to Armagh one day with his wife, and she was around visiting all the museums and all the places that they visit around Armagh, the cathedrals and the planetarium and so on. And he decided he'd go up to the golf club and see if he could get around the golf. And he was a very accomplished golfer, this guy apparently. He met the captain. And he says, don't you have a wonderful course out here? I'd love a game, you know. And the captain says, well, as a matter of fact, I'm on holidays this week. You know, what about tomorrow morning? Why don't we go out for a round? And the captain says, your man says, oh, that'd be great, fabulous. The captain says, what time? And your man says, look, about 9:20. So the next morning, the captain was on the tee box at 9:00. Your man arrived and went and played. He went down to 1 under par. Fantastic. He never played the course before. 1 under par. So into the bar, had a beer. He says, that's a wonderful course you have. I wouldn't mind another round. So the captain says, what about tomorrow morning? He says, great. What time? At 9:20. So we went out the next morning, met him at 9:00. Both boys teed up, played out. This time your man played left-handed, like Paddy Connolly. Mm-hmm. And he came in, he went around the level par. So in the whole bar, your man said, the captain says, yes, you've got fantastic golf. You've got in this club like you. You can play right-handed one day, go around in 1 under par. Go around the next day, you're level par. You're fantastic golf. What's the idea? Well, he says, it depends, he says, which, when I go to bed at night, which way the wife's sleeping in the bed. I said, what do you mean? He says, well, I slip in the bed there, which is lying snoring, and he says, she's lying on her right side, I slip in behind her, and I lay on the right side. But next morning, I play right-handed. And she's lying on her left side, I slip in on the left-hand side. And I go next morning, I play left-handed. That's just the way it is. And the captain says, well, what happens if she's lying on her back? He says, that's why I said 20 pounds. You know, I don't think I'm meant to be captain. I want to blame Donald Maganini for being captain up here. I didn't really want to be, didn't think I'd be captain, but it just drifted in. I remember, I say it to him lots of times, as you probably realise, but I said to Donald when he was king captain, I says, Donald, anything you want, you ask me, I'll do it for you. And that's it. You never go back near me. Like. Don was with me about 6 weeks. He said, I wonder who did this and this, you see. And then I started doing things. So, and that's the way it drifted on and so on. And being captain of sports this year has been fantastic. There's been a lot of good things has happened. You know, like hosting other club captains, meeting a lot of club captains from other areas, playing with them, hosting big corporate days here. The Northern Ireland Centre for the Blind was run out. Going up to Carton House and been out there recently for the official opening of, like, things like that you don't think you get, and it's fantastic. But there was one evening that stood out for me more than anything, and it was the 1st of June. 1st of June just passed there. Oh, 6. Hope not losing it. It was a very relaxed, enjoyable evening in the clubhouse. It was totally different, and I happened as the captain to convene it, and the president was involved, Pierce. And it was, I thought, a wonderful evening, and it was the launch of a wonderful book called Ireland and the Ryder Cup. And I have it here in front of me. It's a fabulous, if you see it in the bookshelves around the country, it's written by a member of our club. And if, some people don't know it, but that's it. That was a wonderful evening. And it's written by a former captain of Ben Burke, but we're delighted he's a member of our club, Paul Kelly. And I was delighted to be able to ask Paul to the dinner this evening to join us, and he's here, and I don't know whereabouts he is, but where are you, Paul? It's great that you come along. Okay, and thanks for that. Just quickly go through the year itself. I just want to say thanks to our past Captain Davey for helping me along, our Vice Captain Jack, our President Pierce, and of course the ladies. You know, sometimes we have, somebody said this about the ladies and that, but I like the ladies, you know. You know, they do an awful lot of good work in this club. It's fantastic, and I would advise captains in the future, keep in with the ladies, because you never know when you're stuck. They will sort you out. And I certainly want to very much include the lady captain there. Just going on, I know Captain Knight's traditional to thank people, and I'm going to be no different to the previous captains. And in no particular order, well, not really any particular order, but I put the course first of all. If we hadn't the course that we have, we wouldn't. It's just a fantastic course, and we have a big membership here. And I just want to thank the greenkeeping staff for the wonderful condition that the course has been in, not just this year, but over the years. And the course and the development officer, John White, assisted by our past captain, Davey. But the man is up to the forefront every day and gets a lot of criticism from time to time, Tom Calvert, our Greens convener. I had dinner with the greenkeeping staff yesterday. I never knew those boys could drink as much. Absolutely. And we'll have to talk about Glenn now, you know, I have to sort Glenn out. We have a wonderful course, but we have, I would say, going around a lot of clubs, we probably have more competitions than most clubs. And I know I would be sort of half involved in the fixture list, along with, of course, because I'm a sponsorship convener for my troubles this year. But as happy for the last 10 years. But Marty Oliver. Marty is a competition convener. I think the people around the club, as you know, Marty, knows how many hours he puts in, the work he does, how diligent he is, and so on and so forth. I'll just give you a little example. I was Warren Pint last week playing with Tommy Magan, and he says, "What did you have in that two-ball classic last week, Tommy?" And I said, 54 pints. We had 54 pints. What I had in the back nine, I said 27 pints. He says, "We had 29. How do we not get a prize? We had 54 too." You see, so Marty, Tommy contacted, and Marty, of course, checked the card, and of course, the boys had, at the seventh hole, of course, they put in two scores, you know, 4 points instead of two, so Marty was right again. He never misses any. So, Marty, I just want to thank you on behalf of the club for the tremendous work that you do, and I know you have everything spot on in a few minutes' time. With our competitions, and of course, with our sponsorship, we need some public relations and so on and so forth. And we're very lucky to have Richard Stewart. So this is a bit of a coup with Damien Murray a few years ago. We get Richard in as our PRO. He's the editor of the local Gazette. Very handy. But we have two guys who link with him very much. Kevin Boyd, who's doing a fantastic job, basically in getting the photographs of the paper and the reports but Bill Edgar, who works the website, fantastic. Our handicap secretary, John Lowe, is coming this year. He's doing a good job. He actually warned me one day that general play cut might be in order, but because of the captain, he might go easy on me. So, John, you're a great fella. Catering convener, Johnny Brown. A little difficult year, you know, a little things, as we know in the club this year, but he sorted things out, and thank you, Johnny. And thank you, Ivan, as the bar convener. The society convener is working well on keeping an eye on things, is Jerry McCreesh. And I'd just like, at this point, to wish Jerry all the best. Jerry hoped to play in captaincy after a major operation. He had planned to play today. Don't push it. I'm sure he'll be out there playing in a few weeks. So Jerry, the club, wish you all the best. I'm down here, the treasurer, you know, the treasurer's a lot of work because he's a terrible man, you know, to get money off, but he does a tremendous job, and more than the rest of us would know. And sometimes criticise Torley, he's cutting this and cutting that and cutting the other, but he has to do that, so thanks Torley for that. For those people who maybe come to the clubhouse for the first time, maybe you like the clubhouse and lovely views and so on, but it's sort of, we add on bits and pieces to it and so on and so forth. Sorry, that better, Pierce? I was trooping. The girls never told me that, Pierce. We have Pat McAlevey as our developer, and Pat has done a lot of work with architects and so on and so forth, but I suppose at this point, and it's something that I have failed this year in relation to maybe fundraising, getting money, and this is something I think for the second half of the year, the last 5 months, and maybe into the 2007 and Jack's year, that we have to really get something going so that Pat and John White, our development man on the course, can have some money to really develop the course more and improve the clubhouse. So, but thanks for the work so far to date, Pat. Teams convener Paddy Duffy looks after all the team captains. It's not an easy task, you know, but we had a good bit of success this year. A number of more teams qualified out for the GUI, but I think at the moment we have been, well, not sure, there's a few teams left, but I hope that we can build on what we have started this year in the team situation. Okay, I went on to 3 teams this year, and some of the boys kept saying, "You only go home because he's the captain," you know. But They never saw me play. I'll talk about that later, Gary. The website convener, well, I don't know what he is. I wouldn't call him a website convener. I'd call him everything. He's just a wonderful guy to get things done. He has helped me enormously for this day with name tags and prize tags and video and you name it, and the people remember back to Aladdin just before Christmas, the work he put in there, and he just does things off and off, and that's, I think, we don't appreciate him enough. Cormac Knott. From County Leith, let me tell this.
Back here, by it from
Allah. Wild boy. last year, there was nobody to take on entertainments. You know, we need an entertainment convener, and I maybe put a wee bit of pressure on a good friend of mine, and Tommy Macken, come up with the goods. Tommy has done a tremendous job. Obviously, cut the expenditure because we had to do that, but has been very professional in everything that he has done in relation to the bands and so on and so forth. And I'm hoping he's got a good band here, mate, and so I'm told. And I want to stop speaking soon so they can start playing. In relation to entertainment, there's one man I have a great time for, who does a tremendous job, particularly in the winter time, and that's Brendan Toner, who organised the Brendan's Ball.
Now he's taken up retiring, I think. I don't know whether when the time changes in the end of October when he'll get we got back, I don't know. But Brendan knows down deep in my heart the work that he does and the amount of revenue brings into that bar to a very simple concept. And I'd also, in entertainment, the two guys that organise quizzes here, week in, week out, particularly in the winter season, Desi and Emmett. Come at 8:29, they say. That's when it starts. The juvenile convener, Walter, and together with his helpers, Eamon O'Hagan and Gary McCourt. And I have recently been at a few matches where the Ronan Rafferty team is really going well underneath Gary. They had a wonderful win here against Monaghan Castle here on Wednesday, and they're into the semi-finals. And I'm not too sure, but I think the semi-finals are played in the morning and then they go on to play the final that evening. So we're really hoping that those young boys maybe bring home the Ronan Rafferty Cup to Armagh this year. There's these equality issues as well to be sorted. I know it's coming very close, and I'm glad I'm getting offside at the end of the year. It's going to be left to Jack. But Ian O'Hare is working on that, and I'm not exactly sure what the situation is, so I'm just mentioning it, but I don't know much about it. Is that fair enough? I'll come to a couple of more people who, in my opinion, are the hardest working members of this club. I've mentioned a few times tonight, and I make no apologies in mentioning Brendan Smith again. He is this club, I think, looking better than it's ever done before. And he's on site here, day in, day out, working with a lot of people. And Brendan, I think you're a credit. Brilliant stuff. Well done. And I can't leave out the Honorary Secretary because, as I say, he's there all the time when troubles seem to hit you. He's always a smoothing hand on your shoulder or a whisper in your ear, and then he might even buy you a drink. I don't think I could describe it, but when we talk to people, you're just a wonderful guy. You are so helpful in every respect, and he keeps you right, as I said, in occasions like this, what's the etiquette for this, this, and this. And Pat does a huge amount of, not only this year, but I don't know how long back in this club, it's enormous the amount of work he's done. Well done, Pat. I'm just going to finish off with thanking the people just for the concern this weekend, this the captain's weekend, which is always a busy weekend, and these are personal sort of thanks. I would just like to thank Jackie Murphy and Alan Magwood here for the lighting and setting up the prize stand and so on and so on. I don't have an idea, but these things, they just make it, it's probably go away, it'll be okay, make it very, very easy. We had live commentary of Captain Say today, as we do most Captain Says, but we had it today as well on the big screen and on the small screen as the boys went out and we watched it during the coffee morning. And I want to thank Raymond Ash for his live coverage of the events from the first tee and the 18th and the 3rd and so on and so forth. It was fabulous. By the way, I never knew Johnny Palmer had such a bad swing. I want to thank the caterers, and I'm going to make no apologies for thanking them for the food that they have produced this weekend. It's not easy in County Armagh. Everybody gets a meal, that's it. Everybody who plays golf, Friday and Saturday. And I got rave reports about the meals that were served up for the golfers yesterday and today. Fabulous. I was delighted with the buffet meal that we had tonight. I know maybe some people in there, it's difficult in a small clubhouse, but we had to move up and down to get ourselves, and maybe took a wee bit long. But that's the way it is in Armagh. And I just want to thank Dolores, Celine, Claire, Caroline, Karen, Kelly, and all the gang up there. Fantastic. I'd like to thank the bar staff, particularly Barbara and Jono, and all the staff. For keeping the drink flowing through our members. It's been a tough weekend. And, of course, Ian, our caretaker. Don't forget Ian, he does a lot of work in the early hours of the morning when we don't see him. So thank Ian. And just to finish off, I'm going to have to mention the ladies. Because as I said earlier, we cannot get anything done without the ladies. And first of all, I'd just like to thank June McParland in the office. Such attention to detail, things that I wouldn't have known about because of her experience over the years. Like, yes, she says, Patty, is the flag up? I never thought of the flag going up. But apparently it was up in Captain Step. Little things like that, attention to detail, she's absolutely, and I would like to thank her so much for all her help during this year. I would like to thank the Lady Secretary, Mara. She keeps me sort of right on a whole lot of wee delicate issues. And if you'd have come this morning that I didn't know about, and she whispered in my ear, do this, do that, it keeps me right. And then the ladies don't be talking about me then next week. So thanks, Maya, for those little things that are so important. Maya's my mixed partner as well. Just talking, did you hear the joke about it was a story in the local club about the, it was the final of the mixed foursomes. A very prestigious trophy. And there was this husband and wife couple were playing against this other couple. They weren't married, they were just another couple who just played together. And it went down to the 18th hole. And this microphone's falling anyway. Can you hear me? So this is important, isn't it? So it came to the 18th green, and the lady had a tap in to win the mixed match play foursomes title. So the husband went over to her and he lined her up and he says, now it's just slightly to the right of the hole, just hit it to the right hand side and it'll drop in, no problem, okay. So she moved away and she lined up and he saw her sort of shaking. And she hit the putt and she just pulled it left of the hole. And he went up and then he tapped it in. So only got only half the match. Instead of winning the match, it went down the 19th, sudden death playoff. And the other couple won. I went to the clubhouse and had gin and tonics and high tea and a few beer, whatever. But on the way home, driving down the road, the husband says to his wife, he says, see that putt you missed on the 18th green? It was no longer than my dick. And she looked over and laughed and smiled and said, yeah, no, it was much harder. I'd like to thank Hilary Johnson and Johnson's Bakery and the committee for the wonderful coffee morning this morning. It was fabulous. And I believe that the Sidona Juvenile Girls, who qualified for the All-Ireland semi-final yesterday at Knock, were out there dishing all the stuff out, so I'd love to thank them as well as the ladies, for the wonderful spread we have this morning. Thank the ladies again for the flower display. Catherine, Bernie, Audrey, Ronnie, and Rosemary. Without those ladies, you know, I don't know where we'd be. They're just brilliant. They make things so easy. And this morning I come down about 8:15 to display my prizes here. And you know, I'm not too good at this. I'm not too artistic. I don't know how they look, but do them, Michael. But Alison Maglett offered to do that for me. And I come down this morning and we move them around and we change them around. And I think we've got them not too bad. But I was saying at that time, you know, Alison, unwrap that stuff very gently, you know, that belief, that beautiful Fermanagh stuff. Unwrap it gently, because I think with this rain, we're going to be putting it back in again. And I seriously did think that. But she said, no, it'll be okay. So it was. So Alison, I want to thank you very much indeed. Finally, I'd just like to thank the family for being here. Steve and Jackie and the grandkids were here this morning. They were flying around the place, Lucy and James. And I'm delighted that Tommy, Seamus, Michael, and particularly my sister Anne is here. Okay. I don't see that much. But I want to thank one person very much who's kept me on the straight and narrow for a few years now. I know I have to. Mickey Grant says I have to be kept on the straight and narrow, and that's Eileen. Eileen, I want to thank you very, very much for that. Thank you very much.
Mr. Captain, we're going to go straight into the prize giving, and we'll start off with the juvenile girls' 9th grade competition, and it was won by Aideen McGranson. Right, we're going to the juvenile girls, the 18 hole competition, and unfortunately she's gone on holidays as the runner up, and it was Judith Humphreys with 38 points. And the winner with 41 points, another Mike Browns, is Kiva.
Mr. Vice Captain, Madam Captain, Madam Vice Captain, ladies and gentlemen, I am delighted to be up here tonight to receive this prize from the Captain, and I would like to wish him luck for the rest of his year. I'd like to thank my playing partner, Alexandra Maloney, for her patience and encouragement, and also Eileen and all the other ladies for their efforts and organisation, not only this year, but for the past number of years. Thank you.
Well done, Katie. We go to the juvenile boys in second place with a net 63, Mark Shannon. And the winner of the juvenile boys with a net 59, Paul Kerr. I think Paul's gone somewhere else, but somebody who's coming up here on a regular basis to get prizes, and now taking his son's prize. You will give it. Turn to your finger. We'll move on to the ladies' putting competition that's held today. The winner with 35 putts, Marjorie Thompson.
Thank you.
We'll go now to the ladies' competition, and the runner-up was net 67, Rosalie Murphy. Competition with the net 63, Ann Murphy. To the country and student member, and with the net 67, John Morgan. Captain says one yesterday and one today. He played in the goal today. I hope he got a prize for each of them. Right, we go to the council and committee member with also a net 67, Ian Lochran. Captain and committee, and with a net 67, Paddy Lochran.
Thank you.
Captain, Lady Vice Captain. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very pleased. It's a very rare occasion and a critical phrase nowadays. And I'm particularly pleased to get putties. As a matter of fact, I set out to get it, but it's very seldom when you set out to get it that you do. And on behalf of past captains, I'd like to thank him for all his efforts for the club and for the praises that he's presented today. And I look forward to him as a competitor for past captain's prize next year. Thank you.
We're going now to the category prizes in the 0 to 12 handicap section with a net 66 on the back nine. Jimmy Wilson. Jimmy Wilson. We go on to the 13 to 18 handicap section with a net 65 on the back nine, Biggie Mann. In the 19 to 20th handicap section with a net 64 on the back nine, Jerry Doyle. Gross 73, Daniel McEnany. Net 64 on the back nine was Ali Wilson.
Thank you.
And the main prize leaves the town or city tonight, and it's not going to Fermanagh. It's going to Keady. I've just been given the winner a little tuition on the alternative language on the course, because I'm led to believe down the first he called one of his playing partners a love child. But it doesn't sound the same as a love child, does it? The others that know what he called his partner. But I'm going to give you his name anyway, Richard Dorman. Richard had a 63. Lady Captain, and fellow golfers. Where do I start? This is totally unexpected. My wildest dreams. I could go into 18 holes and tell you exactly what happened, but all I can say is that I was aided and abetted by two young gentlemen from Keady, Kevin Moan and Hugh McIlvanan. One who outdrew me by 6 inches on the first fairway. I really enjoyed my round of golf. It was actually quite good after 9 holes, and I was trying to protect it. I chipped in at the 9th and then did the usual medical thing, had a double bogey at the 10th. It was called post-birdie syndrome. The course was in great shape, and I have to say, from what the captain was saying, it's with great pride that I bring people, I have friends who play golf around the world in places. When I bring them to play here, they're surprised at the quality of Armagh Golf Course, and I'm really proud to be part of this place and the course. I would like to thank the grand staff for the quality of the course and the way it's been kept. I'd like to thank the bar staff and the kitchen staff for staying up so late, because we were the last in last night. A wonderful meal and plenty of drinks to keep us going afterwards. On one other point I would like to say, I'd like to thank Conor McKenna for helping me to change something that was very ugly over the last 5 years into something that might be half like a golf swing. So we're getting there. And Conor, I have to thank Conor for all his help over the last 5 years. And finally, Mr. Kelvin, thank you very much for a wonderful day, for wonderful prizes. For also giving me an extra month to get myself into the right shape for the whole day. But thank you very much, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, Richard, for all the thanks to the captain. I'd like to now call for the second vote of thanks, Donald McAneely, who will entertain us, no doubt.
Thank you.
Lady Captain, Mr. Vice Captain, Lady Vice Captain, ladies and gentlemen. It is my privilege to second the vote of thanks to our Captain Paddy Burns. He and I have been friends for many years, and a very loyal friend he has been to me. Paddy is very efficient and persistent in everything he does. Every job must be done right. I asked him to give assistance in looking after sponsorship in my captain's year in 1988. In case you don't remember, that was the year we had two captains dead. We nearly had that today again. Paddy plunged himself into the job in hand and did so with great enthusiasm. We all know how good a job he has done with sponsorship in the years since then. Paddy has shown the same enthusiasm and drive since he took over the captainship this year. He has involved himself in all areas of the club and spends many hours making sure that everything is done properly. Our captain has a great passion for all kinds of sport. Obviously, golf is number one this time, and certainly being captain has not affected his handicap. In fact, he is playing the best golf of his life, and this year he has represented his club on a number of teams. I know that has given him great pride and satisfaction. Paddy has a great interest in Gaelic football and his beloved Fermanagh. In his younger days, he represented his county with distinction and enjoys recalling stories and people that he met during that period. Then there's Arsenal. Everybody in the club knows Paddy supports Arsenal. We have had many great nights in our house arguing about Arsenal and Liverpool and Man United. We have Liverpool and Man United supporters in our family, so that would cause the debates. Our captain gets so involved in arguing and debating that I am led to believe that he is sometimes called the clock because he is so easily wound up. We must not forget that Paddy also played rugby for Armagh, although I am not quite sure if he was called Paddy Burns when the papers were reporting on the matches. That was the time of the ban. So as you can see, his sporting interests are varied and wide, but in 2006, County Armagh Golf Club is top of the list. I am sure that you all will join me in thanking our captain for his enormous contribution to our club in 2006.
Thank you very much, Donald. The proceedings are nearly concluded. To finalise them, I would ask the captain if he could come up and present a bouquet of flowers to the lady captain. I also ask the lady captain if she would make her way up here again, please. I'm going to go to the hospital. Can I ask the president's wife if she can come up for the company present for a real big day of flowers, please? Flies for us. The captain sat down because he's not representing him. Could I ask the beautiful Irene again? If she would stand up to represent her, a bouquet of flowers. Ladies and gentlemen, I know it's a long night and I want to get to the bar and hear a bit of music, but could I ask as a final comment, could all the prize winners go up to the hallway so we can take a good photograph, please, so we can put it in the paper? Thank you very much for your attention. Good night.
Let me do it. Thank you. Sometimes, oh. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.